Ladies and gentlemen, this is Adam Kokos here in Omaha, Nebraska with Owen Benjamin, longtime comedian, 16 years in the business, a lot of mainstream commercial success, and killing it on YouTube with a live show right now. And we're here at the Unconvention, and it was really a great thing to be able to hear you talk tonight, and especially about the online censorship, because what you were able to connect it to was the virtue of comedy being the court jester, being the truth teller, that you're telling the truth that no one else will.
Yeah.
How has that affected you? You've been banned on Twitter. Yeah. What other censorship have you faced online?
I was permanently banned on Twitter, and then Patreon told me that I was on their bad list as well. But I think it's really important that this doesn't happen. The shadow banning that we were talking about earlier, where you can have hundreds of thousands of followers and they make it so they don't see that you've uploaded, is this creepy little trick that's almost Black Mirror level dystopian, where they're almost saying like, hey, we know it's what you like more than you like. You like nonsense, you know? And so I'm just a free speech absolutist, because all the other freedoms fall down if you get rid of our ability to talk about ideas.
Are you on Facebook?
I am on Facebook, but they've told me, you know, I'm on the verge of constantly being banned. You know, Zuckerberg is pretty much just texting me frowny faces at this point.
Yeah, I've had experiences on all these platforms, and you have gotten, like, in the libertarian community, I mean, you describe yourself as a libertarian, but this is, like, your first, like, real, I mean, how much have you done political in the past?
Very little. I mean, I've done stuff with Molyneux and Dave Smith, and Vince Vaughn's a libertarian. I used to tour with him, so it's like, my ideas are just very liberty-based, but I'm from the mindset that politics is just one part of our life, and I just do my job, and now it seems like the state's expanded to a degree where we can't avoid it, you know? It's like, you're an architect. Are you a red-pilled architect? You know, it's like, I just draw houses, I draw buildings, you know?
Yeah.
And I think that it's getting to the point where they're just cranking up the heat, where politics are invading, you know, the NFL, just everything. You know, Twitter, like what I said to get banned was so juvenile and nothing. You know, like, ISIS still is on Twitter, like, hashtag super hate America. And I just make fun of David Hogg, and I get, like, David Hogg, the most easily mocked person in the world.
This was the one tweet that got you banned on Twitter, right?
For life.
What was it? I want to let you say it, because it's really good.
Well, I just said, David Hogg, if you don't have pubes, you can't tell grown men not have guns. It's just a basic thing. And then they were misinterpreting it intentionally, saying, like, oh, why are you thinking about little kids' pubes? I'm like, I would have said chest hair, but I didn't want to alienate the Asians.
Oh, man. So what you said about being a libertarian, like, do you affix that label now to yourself?
Not really. I just,
yeah, I screwed it up already. See, that's the thing, is I should just be like, yeah, he gets it. It's cool. But and then I had to get all political with him. Like, you're a libertarian,
I'll
right?
I'll talk about anything, bro. I'll talk about if I'd kill a guy, like why I'd kill a guy. Like, dude, I'm a big what would you do and would you rather guys. Like, if I wake up with 9 dicks on my forehead, like, what do I do about it? Dude, there is nothing that you want to talk about that I won't talk about. That's what makes me free and banned.
So, I mean, this is really interesting, because, like, I live in an area that's super rural. I live down 3 miles of dirt road. And, you know, the most famous story of the last year in our community is when a guy kind of lured a cop to his house and they shot him, like, the whole family, like, shot the cop, and you're just like,
why'd they shoot the cop?
Whoa, because he was chasing them on a private property,
right on.
And this is a very, very private anti-law enforcement kind of community.
But did they lure him, or was the cop being a was it an authoritarian
situation? It wasn't to lure is an exaggeration. It wasn't, yeah, right, no, it wasn't like that. It was like he chased a guy on a four-wheeler. And the guy on the four-wheeler went home, and I was like, well, from my own property, I'm going to shoot you for invading my property. So there are people like, you're the comedy equivalent of that.
Yeah, I would do things to show I can. Like, I kept calling Justin Trudeau a very taboo racial pejorative, not because I enjoy the word, but because he isn't black, and I was showing him that he can't ban words. Because, like, they were trying to get rid of Mother's Day and Father's Day. And I was like, all right, I'm going to, in front of a few hundred thousand people, call you something a little more intense.
All right, so I want to back up on something. There's a very important subject to libertarians, talking about monetary policy and where money comes from and how government uses a coercive fiat currency system to rip everybody off,
yeah.
Right? And so we're really excited about Bitcoin. And you called Bitcoin just tonight What is it? What is it?
Gold
for people with autism.
With Asperger's.
Asperger's. Yeah, okay. And that's it's funny because it's true.
I'm into it. Don't get me wrong. I just need a better explanation of how to do it. So many of my buddies are all like, I'm like half my friends are like real into this. Like to the point where my next special, I was thinking about only selling it on crypto. Because I want people to use it, not just think it's some sort of like fun thing.
Okay, so you're there, you're just not quite at the technical grasp to have confidence in
it
yet.
The thing is people don't even understand cash, they're just born to it.
I always make that point, like, we ask the average American, where does money come from? How does the dollar work? And exactly. I don't have any idea, but it's just, it's whatever everybody's been using, so they use it, right?
That's why people can outbreed ideologies, because when you're just indoctrinated from a child, like, try to explain to somebody that there's no gold backing money, and it's just based on force and bombs and printing. Like, at least crypto hypothetically has something to it. I just don't quite have the calculus background to understand it. Boys do, though. I have friends that tell me, they're like, people I trust that are like brilliant mathematicians are like, this is legit.
And part of the point is you don't have to.
Right?
What do you mean?
You don't have to understand it. We can just make it work. Like, here's the product
that I get behind.
Let's use the dollar.
I understand the dollar, and I'm terrified of the dollar. I support crypto. I just want to understand what this mining is and like how people can't hack it. But then again, I'm not good at this type of thought. I'm 38, you know? I feel like I might have missed the boat on some of these ideas. Like, I'm like, but what's the value? Where's the shininess? Like, I'm a gorilla.
Well, you should have bought it. You missed the boat in, like, buying in. If you didn't buy in, you know, in 2009 when Bitcoin was less than a penny. But the main boom in cryptocurrencies is yet to come. And there's one thing I want to pitch you on real quick, just as something to think about. Because, you know, Gandhi, be the change you wish to see in the world. I know it's
Gandhi
such a stupid
cliche.
Gandhi
was also a pedophile, though.
I have to point that out.
Always. I don't like these false heroes. Gandhi was not a good dude. Anyway, but I like that quote. Now, be the change.
Well, I think 100% everybody who you say the same thing about MLK, just to put up like the next big name next to Gandhi's, right? Well, or a great guy who had a dark side.
Phil Hartman.
What did Phil Hartman do?
Nothing. He's a great guy.
All right, Phil Hartman for great guy.
Yeah, like Vince Vaughn is a way better guy than Gandhi. He's just a normal dude who talks really fast and smart.
It was pretty funny too.
Slept with his nieces. Like, that's horrifying. Like, Martin Luther King Jr. ripped off his entire doctorate. Don't get me wrong. I've cried listening to Mountaintop. I get it. Like, I'm on board. He's a great speaker. I have a dream. I get it. But the dude ripped off, like, he plagiarized his whole doctorate. And no one cares. Everyone's like, that's great. That's awesome.
But all the good that he did.
Yeah, I mean, he did some good.
I'm not disputing. I think realist history is really important. But what I wanted to get at was in being the change right now.
Yeah.
You know, you want to bring about a world where censorship isn't an issue, right?
In the crypto that you want to see in your crypto wallet.
So there is a cryptocurrency-based social media platform called steemit.com, and I just highly recommend you get on that. I want to help you get a leg up there. I'm doing pretty well because I've been there for a couple of years.
Board,
awesome. We're going to talk afterwards. We're going to make sure that he starts making money on steemit.com, because when YouTube decides to cancel you, you're going to want somewhere else to go.
I just had two strikes that I had to get a lawyer to get down.
Wait, they have lawyers that'll actually address that on YouTube for you?
I had a guy. I got a Jew.
I'm Jewish. Even I don't get to do that.
I'm a quarter. I didn't even know.
Now we're like, it's like reverse anti-Zionism. We're like bragging about how Jewish we are.
Yeah, no,
I'm Jewish where it counts.
I'm 75% Scandinavian and 25% Jewish. And I didn't even know I was Jewish until I was 20, but I always knew I was up to something.
All right. So I want to ask your thoughts about one more thing, because someone recently, a fan of mine, suggested that you should be my running mate. And it was like, you have some fans out there who really do want to see you make a crossover into serious politics. Of course, I have to explain, you know, that my platform is getting rid of the entire federal government. We're going to dissolve it in a peaceful, orderly manner, leave us with 50 independent states, 5 autonomous territories, and up to 562 sovereign native nations in the first important step in decentralizing power down to the community level. Is that something you could get behind?
Yeah, I just don't know how to decentralize from within, because it's almost like you have to commit to the game to do it. I can't explain it.
Well, so there's that's a problem that a lot of people from the anarchist perspective really raise it.
Yeah, no, it is. It's and you got to kill a stranger. That way you're already felon. And so whatever.
I already am a felon, actually, but I didn't have to kill anybody.
Everyone's a felon every day.
Three felonies a day now.
The legal code is so long, everyone's a felon. So listen, bro, I don't judge you.
Okay, so you're
I'm a misdemeanor guy.
I'm disappointed. You're not qualified.
I'm a misdemeanor.
So the concept though is that we're going to turn the presidential election into a referendum on whether or not we should have the federal government at all. And if the American people say, decisively, irrefutably, we are not going to let this continue any longer, no asshole in a suit in Washington, D.C. is going to stand in our way. No congressman, no Supreme Court justice, no senator, no other bureaucrat is going to say, oh, no, well, that you didn't follow the rules. You didn't. If the American people say overwhelmingly through the presidential process, no, you know what, we don't need a president. We can be free. We don't need a central government. We can decentralize power. Then the technicalities of how that is carried out don't really matter. Like, I've made the commitment with this platform. I'm doing one thing as president, and that's essentially resigning. I'm going to go in, sign one executive order.
Then you taste the power. You get a little hunt. You get a little honey.
I got the answer to that too. So, because if we have this referendum nationally,
they got to kill you if you don't rebel.
Yeah, you're so close. You are so close. So I tell people, look, if I get in there and on day one they bring me the executive order to dissolve the federal government, I go no. Bring me the dictator for life one instead. Shoot me. Because at that point, it won't matter. Now,
hire guys to that guy.
Well, I hope you can find a way to take me away in a straitjacket and not actually have to kill me. But the point is, there will have been a paradigm shift. The American people have said, we're not putting up with this. And the technicalities of it don't really matter. But we declare the federal government of no authority. Everybody who's in prison for victimless crimes, all the drug crimes, immediately pardoned and released. And we initiate the process where every agency is either spun off, like we take Social Security. We take the money that we get from selling other assets and we make Social Security solvent for longer than it would be under government, and you give plenty of time for a transition to someone better. Some agencies get localized down to the states. Some just, I mean, you're not going to miss the IRS, are you?
No. I think that you speaking of this, all I care about is moving the Overton window away from the nanny state.
You know, from comedy, this isn't about the Overton. Well, you know, from comedy, you can say way crazy. You can talk about assassinating presidents. You can talk about, peeing with on hookers.
A different Overton window. The one about...
The serious one.
Yeah, no, the one about free will versus determinism, where people literally think that someone else has to control them because they've been raised by nannies. Where I think that you just have to push people away from that through strong cultural... I don't even know, man. I'm worried about... I got three words for you. Soy, corn syrup. These people are fat and they're losing their testosterone. Gay frogs.
They're making the frogs gay. Sorry, it was too easy of a setup.
No, I think a lot of people are just, they haven't seen anything explode or a lot of people are just so bored and dumb that they're almost like, tell me what to do and I'll do it. Man, I don't even...
That's the difference between the comedy and to me, the activism. This is why a lot of people who appreciate your voice and your comedy want to see you become more of an activist. Because you're content sitting on the side as a comedian and being really fucking funny and getting an audience and being hilarious.
I still move culture. Like, that's the thing. It's politics is downstream from culture. So it's like when you start making, freedom cool again and not like this whole, like, Amy Schumer, my pussy thing, it's like... That has resounding effects on the culture. We're like I post pictures of my family a lot because I'm trying to get people to have families because family is the ultimate antidote to the state. Like if you have a wife and a child or a husband and a child and grandparents, like you're not as easily affected by the nanny state. No one's going to be like, oh, we're here for you. I'm Justin Trudeau. Everyone's like, no.
Molyneux's idea of raising children with this attitude as human beings.
That's the way it is because they're you can't affect them as much. They have like a shield where if someone's like, a lot of these kids have been abused and neglected and it's so easy for someone to be like, hey, I'm your buddy. It's almost like this weird Stockholm syndrome that the government's done.
I think you're really right about the cultural element. I would just want to point out one thing that what if the culture has already shifted enough to accept some kind of fundamental political change?
Oh,
and all we have to do is give it teeth now.
No, I hear you. I support that. Give it teeth. Teeth it up, man.
All right, so are you going to get involved with the Libertarian Party now?
I mean...
Can we count on you running for office?
Maybe.
It's a fun, free platform.
Can I be Treasury and it's just crypto and I don't understand it?
You could be actually
the computer going, I don't know.
This is really funny because I'm assembling a team to be the cabinet for the dissolution of the federal government, where they're not a secretary of whatever, but a custodian or whatever. And for most of them, it's just they're going to walk in and kind of ceremonially sign a piece of paper and be like, ha, you all have to go home now. Yeah. And I think for the Treasury, I think you could handle that. You want to be first in line to be my nominee for custodian of the Treasury. Yeah, but you only get to do it for like a day and then you're done.
No, but see, I need irony. Like, I need to do something hilarious where it's like, if the libertarian Treasury guy would be just laughable.
You quit on day one.
Oh, I'd just be burning fiat currency.
We could have a ceremony and like, yeah, burn a giant pile of $100 bills somewhere. Yeah.
Totally. I'm in.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, your custodian of the Department of the Treasury starting January 2021, coming to a Washington, D.C. as far away from you as possible. Owen Benjamin, you got a website you want to plug, brother?
Hugepianist.com.
Thank you very much.
Oh, dude, you're the man. Good luck to you.
That was a lot of fun.
Yeah, cheers.
Appreciate it. Thank you to YouTube for hosting this video and for being an essential part of human progress by making video hosting available worldwide to everyone on the internet. However, the next phase in human progress is here with Steemit.com and their video hosting alternative blockchain-based solutions, including DTube. And you can find that through Steemit.com as well as my own page there at Adam Kokesh. This is a decentralized blockchain-based social media network that pays you fairly for your content. Already, I'm regularly making more there with a single post than I do from an entire month on YouTube. So please join us on the next frontier of the information revolution at steemit.com. And if you want help getting a leg up there, I'm happy to re-steam your post and make sure that no one is starting from scratch. Just email me one of your favorite posts at adam@thefreedomline.com and we'll share it on my feed.